Those of you who know me know that I'm a big proponent of catch and release, and I'll tell you any fishing you do is going to involve at least some catch and release. However, the fact is fish are good to eat, they're good for you, they're a renewable resource, and we should enjoy at least some of the fish we catch on the table. But I think it's important then to be selective about the fish we harvest. So when I'm going to take some fish to eat, I want to select those fish that are most abundant and can withstand some harvest. That's things like panfish or smaller fish of a larger game fish species. And those are some of the best eaten too, the smaller, younger fish. So that's what I'm thinking of when I'm going to fix a meal of fresh fish. Those are the kind of fish that I'm going to be harvesting. Now, there's some things to keep in mind. I also believe we owe it to the resource to keep those fish in as good a condition as possible so they taste as good as possible. And I will always tell you the best way to handle those fish that you're going to be putting on the table is to put them on ice. Now, ice fishermen know during the ice fishing season we're doing that all the time. But during the rest of the open water season, the best thing to do is get a cooler full of ice, and the fish you choose to harvest probably should go on that ice as soon as possible. That way they'll be as fresh as possible and taste as good as possible when you get them to the table. So let me tell you about how to clean a fish. We're going to go over just a simple filleting technique. And filleting is the technique where a fish is clean so it doesn't have any bones in it. If people tend to turn their noses up at eating fish, it's because of the bones. So if you learn how to clean them without the bones, you can have a nice tasty fillet that you can crunch on and not worry about getting any bones. Some tools are needed. Obviously, you have to have a knife, and you need a good sharp knife. Now, I'm not much of one that's very good at sharpening knives, so if you want, take it to somebody who's a professional or does a good job of sharpening and have them do it for you, or learn how to sharpen a knife yourself. Pick the right tool for the job. There's a variety of fillet knives, and I brought several with me. This is one of my travel knives. It folds up so it doesn't take much space. This is a little bigger, common Rapala fillet knife that is sold almost every tackle shop or sporting goods store. These are very good fillet knives, relatively inexpensive, and will do a good job. You'll get what you pay for to some extent. The more expensive knives have better steel on them, and therefore they hold an edge better, but you certainly don't have to go out and spend lots of money to get a good fillet knife. And then I got this one too. It's a little more hefty, and the point I wanted to make about the different tools is the bigger the fish, then the longer the fillet knife, and also a heftier knife helps you with bigger fish too. But as I mentioned, we're going to be cleaning some smaller fish, some panfish in this video, and so I'm going to use the smallest one I've got. You notice the flexible blade, that's very handy on a fillet knife for filleting fish. So let's get started. I've got some bluegills here in the cooler on ice, and I'll put it in the middle of the cutting board here. And I like to tell people, filleting a fish or cleaning a fish really isn't that hard. I'm somewhat of smart aleck about it, and I just say follow the dotted lines. And by that, you're just going to follow the anatomy of the fish and fillet that flesh, that fillet, right off the bones. So you'll notice the first cut I'm going to make is down to the spine in the middle of the fish. And I'm going to make that cut right behind the gill cover. Now, the gill cover is pretty hard, so you don't want to cut through that. And that's why I say you follow the dotted line. You start right behind the gill cover. Another little trick for making that first cut is the scales all lay like shingles back towards the tail of the fish. So I'm going to make my cut just a little bit towards the head to slip that blade underneath those scales. If you cut through the scales, it's harder to cut and it'll dull your knife. So that initial cut, I'm back towards the head just a little bit until I get through the skin underneath those scales. And then you see I turn my knife and go right straight down. And you'll know when you hit the spine, because that's a fairly substantial bone running through the middle of that fish. Then when I hit the spine, I'm going to come back up to the top of the fish, and I'm going to start a cut right along the dorsal, the top of the fish, on either side of that dorsal spine. Now, we do one side of the fish at a time, so I'm going to make a cut along the top of that fish, along that dorsal spine, along this side. And when I get back here, back behind the vent, you can go clear through, and again, you'll feel that spine, and you just want to slide the flay knife along the spine back towards the tail of the fish. Now, I prefer not to cut all the way through at the table, and you'll see why when I get done here getting this fillet off. So now I've made those two initial cuts. Now with a bluegill of this size, probably what I'll do is go right along that spine, and you're gonna cut through the rib bones on a fish like this. Those rib bones are small enough then that you can cut right through them. A larger fish with larger rib bones, you would come down from the top here and you would cut just over the top of those rib bones. The rib bones will curve out from the spine like that. So you would just use the tip of your knife and tickle along the top of those rib bones and cut the flesh away from the rib bones. So you can do it both ways, but on a fish this size, I usually cut right through those rib bones, following the spine. And you can see now I'm back to where I started that initial cut, and I can flip the fillet over. And that's why I prefer not to cut the fillet all the way off of the body, is now I can hold the fish, and then I'm just gonna take my knife and make a cut right along the skin and take that fillet off the skin. And this is where the flexible fillet knife works really well, is you can get down as close to the surface as possible so you're getting that flesh off the skin as close to the skin as possible. And now I have the rib bones still in that fillet. You can see where I cut right through those rib bones. So now all I need to do is trim those out. And there is a boneless fillet from that bluegill, and that will melt in your mouth when you get done and fry that up. The other side of the fish is just the same. You flip the fish over then, get rid of that rib cage, and you can see it's the other side, so it's kind of a mirror of what you just did. Start through with the initial cut again. And then I'll turn the fish since I'm working on the other side and make that cut along the dorsal fin, now through. It was through, there we go. And along the spine, back to the tail. And now again, I'll cut through the rib cage on this fish. Flip it over and take it off the skin. Oh, I'm glad that happened. You saw that the skin came loose there. I'll show you a little trick. This will happen, especially with panfish. I brought a fork, and I didn't bring the fork because I'm going to eat the fish. If it comes off, then you can hold that skin with the fork and finish taking the fillet off the skin. The fork, well, if you got long fingernails, you can do it, but the fork works better for me. And then I'll trim the rib cage out of that fillet. And there's two fillets from that bluegill. And you can see, if you want to look at the carcass, pretty much read through that because there's very little meat left on there. And all that's left basically is the skeleton of that fish. So that's a basic filleting technique. That's a simple technique that can be used on just about any fish. There's some variations with different species of fish. And of course, everybody has their own little tricks to doing that. So if you want, you can cruise the internet and you can see a lot of different variations on that basic technique. But that is a basic filleting technique that you can use on just about any fish you catch that'll produce some boneless fillets that'll be very good on the table. Like I said, if you keep that meat fresh especially. And then I would recommend eating it fresh too is the best way. Put those fillets on some ice water, get them into the kitchen, and then prepare them whatever your favorite way is. Frying, of course, is the most popular. And again, I like to keep it simple. Maybe a simple coating of cornmeal or some crushed crackers, maybe a little bit of an egg wash, and throw that in some hot oil till it's crispy and it will melt in your mouth.